for some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Amazon and Microsoft after Britain's competition regulator began an antitrust investigation into the two tech giants' dominance in the cloud services sector. Also in focus, shares of UK's Metro Bank, which were briefly suspended twice early Thursday after a volatile session over reports it is seeking to raise millions to bolster its finances. The stock has since resumed trading and is currently down over 22%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of French train manufacturer Alstom after the company slashed its free cash flow forecast. The stock was briefly suspended at the open of the Paris Stock Exchange. Now it is trading lower by 35%, on course for its worst performance in at least 20 years. We're also keeping an eye on Pandora shares, which hiked its growth targets. Shares of the Danish jeweler are up nearly 10% in midday trading.
Oil price is also in focus. That's after Russia said there was no deadline for lifting a fuel export ban. Kremlin spokesperson Dmitry Peskov adds that the restrictions would be in place for as long as needed. Moscow's move again raising the risk of disrupting supply for winter and aggravating a global shortage brought by OPEC cuts. Russia is one of the world's largest suppliers of diesel and a major exporter of crude oil. It imposed a ban last September 21st, saying the move is meant to stabilize fuel prices in the domestic market. Asian markets managed to rise Thursday after U.S. Treasury yields eased from 16-year highs. Leading gains in the region, Japan's Nikkei 225, which closed nearly 2% higher today. Bourses in Australia and Singapore also in the green. On the other hand, the KOSPI index closed in negative territory as South Korea's consumer inflation accelerated for a second month in September. Some notable stock movements in the region: shares of South Korea's Doosan Robotics more than doubled in its trading debut. An analyst attributes a rise on recent high market interest in the robotics sector. Doosan Robotics' shares closed more than a percent higher. Over in Taiwan, Foxconn, the world's largest contract electronics maker, says it expects strong holiday sales in the fourth quarter. Foxconn shares closed nearly 2% higher Thursday. And here at home, Philippine shares tumbled with the main index sliding back to the 6,100 level. That's after September inflation numbers came in higher than expected in September. Regina Capital's Luis Limlingan says the market was caught by surprise.
This did catch many by surprise. They did expect that inflation would hover around 5.5%. But if you look at the numbers, I think you can see why. Market, it's a reflection of the available data, and it's a leading indicator in the sense that if we take inflation, for example, yes, it was disappointing. It's 6.1%. But looking forward, what is going to happen?
Philippine inflation expected to stay elevated in the coming months. The Banco Central na Pilipinas says that's due to the continued impact of supply shocks on food prices and the rise in global oil prices. It adds it stands ready to resume monetary policy tightening to rein in inflation. The BSP's tightening has been one of the most aggressive in Southeast Asia. It has hiked its borrowing rates by 425 basis points since last year to bring its benchmark rate to 6.25%.
Despite a price cap, rice prices soared to a 14-year high in September. But government insists it can't be concluded that the price ceiling was ineffective. Economic managers also assure Filipinos government is all hands on deck to stop the rise in commodity prices. Lady Vicencio reports.
Headline inflation accelerated to 6.1% in September from 5.3% in August. The Philippine Statistics Authority attributed the rise to food and transport prices increasing at a faster pace. Despite the imposition of a price ceiling, rice inflation ballooned by 17.9%, or more than double the previous month's rice inflation of 8.7%, and the highest in 14 years. But the PSA says rice inflation numbers are inconclusive of the effectivity of the price cap.
Yung first phase ng ating data collection, may mga outlets na nagsasabi na inuubos nila yung stocks, no, dito sa regular and wheel milled rice, kaya nagkaroon ng mas mataas na presyo. Yung second phase, doon nagkaroon ng adjustment, mas marami yung masasabi nating compliant, no.
PSA's second phase monitoring showed that not even half of rice varieties covered by the ceiling were compliant. Average national prices in September were also higher than the price ceiling. Rice Watch Group Bantay Bigas is convinced the price ceiling failed.
Very, very hindi siya effective. Mas ang naging victim nga ay yung mga retailers na makarinig ka talaga sa mga retailers na hindi na lang ako magbebenta kaysa magpalugi ako. Talagang mangyayari ang napakataas na inflation.
Economist Nicolas Mapa agrees, adding that supply challenges should instead be addressed.
Food inflation was the main, miss that we weren't expecting. Rice inflation at 17.9%, this just tells us that the price caps implemented were not effective.
But the Presidential Communications Office said the economic team is expecting a moderation in rice prices as the harvest season begins. Previous orders of rice imports are also expected to arrive. Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno assured the public that the administration is all hands on deck when it comes to arresting high commodity prices. Meanwhile, NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan said the government will continue to address long-term supply challenges and support the local agriculture sector. Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.